Jordan Kingsbury right up the middle. Close to an Iowa first down. And it is an Iowa first down without measurement. A game of gain of 10.
Yeah, we're talking about Fellini, one of them in the coaches' booth.
Action for Rudolph. Checks down. Kingsbury makes the man miss. No one home for Nebraska. As Kingsbury hammers his way down to about the 12-yard line. A go route took that back end coverage for Nebraska all the way to the end zone. And when Kingsbury got loose, there was no one there to bring him down.
It's a check down by Rudolph and simply a missed tackle. And that missed tackle by Andrew Green is what opened the door for a huge, huge play.
How many times can you keep doing this to game? The backup quarterback, C.J. Beathard, still in for Iowa. But again starting for the sixth time today in Nebraska territory. A handoff to Kingsbury. Gets to the edge. No one home for Nebraska. Out of bounds inside the one. They'll actually say he is out at the two-yard line, first and goal, Iowa.
Hey, Shu, we've talked about the matchup on the edge. Watch how they control the edge against the defensive end. This time it's Avery Mazza. They control the edge. When you control the edge, you can get outside. That's just a great job over there by Scherff, the left tackle. He's owned that spot all day when they've had success running outside, and you see that.
Kingsbury in the backfield, the single back set. And Kingsbury, a gaping hole. Kingsbury. Down to the three, first and goal, Hawkeyes. A 25-yard gain. That'll get the folks on South Dubuque Street going in Iowa City.
Well, watch what they get here, and then there's a hole that opens up. A good block on the edge over there by Donnell, 78. And then a good push out to the right side. You get the center in there, Gall, 57, helping, opening up a huge hole for Kingsbury.
Wiseman now in a tailback out of the eye. Second down and two. Beathard in the quarterback. He was the one that led them on the touchdown drive at the end of the first half. This is his third straight possession, and one more first by Kingsbury. And a great block out front from none other than Brandon Scherff.
Yep, they went to his side, and like I said earlier, they've done that 41% of the time this year, with good reason. Out.
It's Kingsbury. He's had a lot more success here in the second half. Still on his feet. Down to the 13-yard line. Kingsbury running behind that big offensive lineman, Scherff.
Well, that's the way to...
They set up the screen for Kingsbury. Kingsbury. Nice cutback. Kingsbury. To the edge. Got a block. Kingsbury. Inside the 20 and out of bounds.
And that, my friends, is why you kick it. You punt it, I should say. That was set up beautifully. And it was really well executed by the quarterback. Look how he draws it in, dumps it off, picks up his blocks on the outside, and in Kingsbury is a very nice open field runner. Good block on the backside on the one guy who could have gotten to it by Smith. And now you have a chance at six.
Ball game. A little shovel for Kingsbury. Kingsbury picked his way through traffic and a big game, hurling the tackler into Illinois Smith territory.
And I watched Kingsbury since he's gotten here. And there's something about that kid I just like. I always have. He's got a little bit of extra in him. This is a nice job shoveling through, making sure he gets the ball. But he's pretty good in the open field. One thing you always get out of Kingsbury is all he's got. I think that's the part that I like about him most.
Second and goal at the five. Kingsbury with the carry. Kingsbury into the end zone for the touchdown.
Kev, you have to understand, it's about numbers. And so what Iowa does, Greg Davis is the offensive coordinator, he gets three receivers to one side and he spreads that defense and skews it to their defensive right. And then he takes advantage of the lesser numbers in the box and Kingsbury gets six.
Iowa with plenty of breathing room now at their own 45. Beathard to throw. Steps up.
avoids the rush, dumps it off. It's complete. Kanziri. And Jordan Kanziri will gain 19 yards on the play.
This is made by Kanziri. He's going to come up and block, and then he's going to stay with it the entire length of the play, and he's there for his quarterback. So he comes up. Now he's in the route, and as he sees his quarterback in trouble, he finds the open spot, and he's complete for a first down. That's excellent running back play.
So on two plays for Iowa, gains of 44 and 19 yards. Now they're in Iowa State territory at the Cyclones, 36. Here's the handoff. Kanziri. And he'll smash his way through the line and pick up 9 yards. That's Luke Nye, 7 yards. Kanziri breaks a tackle and goes out of bounds inside the Iowa State 30. Wilkes with the tackle.
You start looking at this push that the offensive line is getting. This line of scrimmage is moving up front. Got these defensive linemen on skates, and Kanziri wasn't even touched until he was back.
10 of the 25. And he'll hand it off. Kanziri getting through the hole, still on the move, and down inside. The Cyclones 10, a 17-yard gain. And look at the ball security on that run.
Well, at least their timeouts and call it a day.
Kanziri, 22 carries, 112 yards. First down and goal at the 8. They'd like to slam it into the end zone one more time. Kanziri, fielding it, smelling it, touchdown! Last week against Illinois State, Kanziri was 118 all-purpose yards on 9 touches. They gave him the rock today.
He became the featured guy for Kirk Ferentz in the second half of the most important game so far of the season, and he has delivered.
On 3rd and 5, Kanziri's in the backfield, Vandenberg in motion. Blitz coming, swing it out. Kanziri makes one hand miss. Wrestled down to the turf by Matt Galambos, the middle backer for Pitt. But that will move the chains for the Hawkeyes.
Well, I'll tell you what made this play go is the left tackle, Boone Myers, number 52. Man, he had to get on his motorcycle and get out there and get the kickout block on the corner where you have no chance. Good hustle.
Has 3 timeouts. This is the 11th play of the drive. Game clock management now. Showing some reverse motion by handing to Kanziri. Webb will get credit for the tackle. A pickup of 7 for Jordan Kanziri, who had 124 yards rushing last week.
Well, you saw
this is 2nd and 3. Iowa can make a first down. 48 seconds to go. Kanziri, similar looking play. Touchdown, Iowa. A 4-yard plunge for Jordan Kanziri. That's hard nose work on the goal line. Kluver will 17-17 in the fourth, a kick. Straight ahead, power running game on display. The hard work of tailback Jordan Kanziri, nets 9. Kanziri, such a spark plug for this team.
They're fighting there. They're getting hat on hat. And Kanziri's running tough. And coaches like 2nd and 1.
On 1st and 10, the give is to Kanziri on the stretch. Kanziri breaks loose inside the 10. There's a flag down. A sharp-looking run from Jordan Kanziri. 17, but it may be coming back. Kanziri's in there. This is 2nd down. Let's call it 16. Number 16 runs away from Jarrett, floats it to Kanziri down the sideline, leaping and hurdling. First down, Iowa.
I hate to say I told you so, but Joe, I'm going to tell you so. What did I say before?
Pitt didn't go for it on fourth and inches. You said it would really hurt if Iowa would make a touchdown.
They go all the way down. You'll second guess not going for fourth down hitting when you know you're getting pressure and you're having trouble handling. It went to the screen there. It worked perfectly.
Beathard under center. Kittle in motion. Kanziri. No signal. Close. Close. Still no call. Touchdown now. Touchdown Hawkeyes. It took him a while to find 33, but he crossed the plane.
The ruling on the field was a touchdown. The play is under review.
Into those high traffic areas around the goal line. Kanziri and his mates fearless as the referee Magellanus hears from video replay official Tom Kissinger checking to see if the football crosses the plane here.
Well, Kanziri really did a good job here because he took a little stutter step, showed a little patience till the little gap down on the goal line opened up, and then he got his pad level down and kept fighting. And they think they got it in.
Glenn, it took a while. The officials were thinking to get the ruling here.
After review, the ruling on the field stands as called. Touchdown.
Around the delay, Kanziri again, a couple of moves into the secondary, into North Texas territory, and finally flipped at the 36-yard line of the mean green.
And they ran that behind the guy who is my impact player, the center, Blythe. It was just right up the middle, and you see there, everybody latching onto their blocks. That's how you pop a big run like that. Everybody doing their job, and Iowa got it there on a big run from Kanziri.
First look at LeSean. Tight formation. Kanziri has some room. And into the end zone, Iowa scores on its opening drive.
This touchdown run by Kanziri. And you'll see on the right-hand side, a big block left to your screen from the tight end, Henry Krieger Coble. Completely allows him to get that cutback lane and go away from the grain of the defense. It's hard to change direction when you're running downhill, and you know you've got to bring your pad with a big back like Kanziri.
Kanziri on that first drive, four carries, 55 yards, including the touchdown. Iowa marking. Three tight ends in the game. Kanziri has some room into the end zone. His second TD. Again, out of a three tight end set. Kanziri has a seam inside the 10. First and goal, Iowa.
They are rolling right now, and Kanziri, a guy who gets behind his pads. When you see him put that foot in the ground and square up those shoulders, only a few people on that side of the ball want to tackle him. He's a real force, and I know you talk about
Kanziri again. Into the end zone, his fourth touchdown of the game. Second down and 10, and they're doing just that. Kanziri on the carry. Put him in a third down situation, TJ Edwards attacking.
And I don't tell you these things to inspire.
At some point, you take a shot, catch somebody by surprise, right?
You break those tendencies.
Here's a run. Hey, whatever, it works out for Kanziri. It's a big gain. Tanner McAvoy.
McAvoy finally brings him down, but after a gain of 15 for Iowa. Looks like Beathard's changing the play at the line of scrimmage. And checks it away, handoff to Kanziri. Has some running room, makes a cut. And he's brought down at the 11-yard line. 19-yard gain. Didn't look like that much was there.
It was a nice job. That's some of their ISO run here. And a really good block once again from his fullback in front of him. Just an isolation play and a one-on-one. And here's the difference, too. McAvoy was their starting quarterback last year. He's been a receiver. He's been a safety. He's a Wildcat quarterback. I'll tell you what he's not on tape. It's a tackler. And I was asking David Ryan.
Down at 15 from the 17-yard line. Now Beathard backpedaling. Kanziri gets it. Out of the backfield. Gets behind a block and goes in. Touchdown.
Good job by CJ retreating on the screen pass, but wow, what a cut and great vision by Kanziri, the senior.
They run it again. Kanziri spinning across the 45 to the 47-yard line. And they'll move the chains again. Here's Chris Cox picking up some of the slack with Tavon Smith out. Kanziri finds a lot of room on the near side. Inside the 15, Fedulum took him out, but it's a 32-yard run for Kanziri, his biggest of the day.
Another big play out of this Iowa offense, and a terrific job of blocking down the field by the freshman Smith. He caught the previous pass on the sidelines, and now he paves the way.
13, Iowa leading. Trying to get to bowl eligibility with a win here today. Kanziri, a big run. 30. Touchdown, Jordan Kanziri, a 75-yard rip. Boy, did the Hawkeyes need that.
That'll wake up this crowd. You've got a senior running back that gets excited with great vision and a terrific cutback run for 75 that really wakes up the offense for Iowa. You have to have good blocking up front. The center does a terrific job of turning back Fotu, the nose tackle, and then terrific vision in an alley on the backside. Just a terrific alley to the backside that allows the senior Kanziri to go 75 yards. So the center in Austin Blythe does a terrific job turning the defensive tackle, and then terrific vision by Jordan Kanziri. Supposed to go left, he goes right. And he goes untouched for the score. Good speed by the 5'9 senior.
Today, a game between two very good defensive teams in the Big Ten. Kanziri trying to cut the corner on the outside and does. Another first down.
What's been the most impressive thing about Kanziri, and you can see the sideline getting excited, is that he's taken the punishment in between the tackles, but he also still has the speed late in the football game to get the edge, to get the corner, and be able to move the chains again.
That was Brian Ferentz.
Fresh set of downs here for the Hawkeyes. Kanziri. Nice block in front of him. Cut back by Jordan. It was Adam Cox leading the way. Another big gainer, 24 yards for Kanziri. The fullback doing his job.
Well, it's senior day, and Adam Cox doesn't get a lot of play, but he's going to make a big block to spring Kanziri. See him come through the offensive line. Watch 38 right on the backer coming around the outside. Really takes two guys out. Jordan Kanziri knows what to do with it. Big plays, their best all-around back. Does everything good. Protects, runs.
And they will now have Iowa on a short week on Friday. And they will have an Iowa team brimming with confidence. Touchdown, Hawkeyes, 42 yards, Kanziri. And perhaps Jordan wanted to say hello as well. They will be heading to Lincoln on Friday with a shot at staying unbeaten.
Here's Kanziri, and he's got a big hole. He got grabbed by the jersey of
linebacker Chris Weber. Had Weber not grabbed him, he may have burst it open for a score.
And Adam Cox is right here, the fullback. He's going to lead up inside, and then that creates the room right there. Two running back set, lead with the fullback, expand the point of attack, and then Kanziri has that speed, and that's why I like him as a more balanced running back for Iowa. They can get bigger, but he brings the pack, the total package.
Fifth in the Big Ten.
Down in the second half, but the wind's still howling, guys.
Yeah, Bethard is going with the wind right now as Kanziri gets a block from Pippa and has open space. Touchdown, Iowa. Jordan Kanziri into the end zone. Back-to-back weeks with a touchdown in his third game back from the ankle injury, and now Iowa has taken a two-score lead.
Offensively is not a high-volume offense, but what they do really well. You can see the lead outside by the fullback, and then Kanziri dashes it up inside. Limited runs, but they do an extreme.
Nearly disastrous play. From the 32, it's where Iowa starts with the lead. Here is Kanziri with a big hole. There goes Jordan Kanziri, and the New York native is going to burst one open for an Iowa rushing touchdown. Yards for Kanziri. Iowa responds in a big way.
Exactly the same play, same design as Kanziri just scored on the touchdown before. Lead with Adam Cox, the fullback, out on the edge. And Nebraska's linebackers took bad pursuit angles, and the secondary was nowhere to be found. Exact same play, Adam, that Jordan Kanziri scored on before.
Second longest touchdown run of his career at a 75-yarder against Illinois. And it's back-to-back Iowa drives that have ended with the ball in Kanziri's belly and then have ended with an Iowa touchdown in the end zone. Kanziri does it again. They respond, and it's back to a double-digit lead.
A couple of things to pay attention to when Iowa has the football.
Offensively, they need to be so balanced, and that starts with their run game and Jordan Kanziri. 12 rushing touchdowns on the season, second in the Big Ten, and only the 14th player in Iowa history to run for over 2,000 yards in a career. Now, this front seven, the ball from his safety position. Boy, so fortunate on the last play.
31st catch of the year for Krager Colbert. A 6-yard gain, second and four. Kanziri breaks it back. He's got speed on first down. Darian Harris with the tackle, but this kid, he's small, 192 pounds, but explosive as he gets up slowly.
He's battled health issues his entire career. He came in with the sore ankle, and he gets up favoring that ankle now.
Missed parts of three games with a high ankle sprain.
Boy, this would just be such a loss for Iowa.
Came into tonight 36 yards away from becoming Iowa's first 1,000-yard back since 2011, and he's in a lot of pain.
This guy has been their leader, lightly recruited from Troy, New York. Iowa was one of the only Division I schools that gave him a real shot, and he has come to Iowa and become one of the best running backs that they've had in their history. And that's always how it generally happens, those defenders starting to roll up on the back of the ankles of the running back.
First down and 10. Play fake. Bethard sets up deep in the pocket. Goes down the field for Smith.
They finally get the safety to bite on a different
Extra point.